Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Revelation 22:6-13. The angel said to me, "These words are trustworthy and true. The Lord, the God who inspires the prophets, sent his angel to show his servants the things that must soon take place. Look, I am coming soon. Blessed is the one who keeps the words of the prophecy written in this scroll. I, John, am the one who heard and saw these things. And when I had heard and seen them, I fell down to worship at the feet of the angel who had been showing them to me. But he said to me, 'Don't do that. I am a fellow servant with you and with your fellow prophets and with all who keep the words of this scroll. Worship God.' Then he told me, 'Do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this scroll, because the time is near. Let the one who does wrong continue to do wrong, let the vile person continue to be vile, let the one who does right continue to do right, and let the holy person continue to be holy. Look, I am coming soon. My reward is with me, and I will give to each person according to what they have done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end." Today's title is "Look, I am coming soon." We Christians do not attempt to escape from the world, even though we encounter a lot of evil in this world. We would rather fight against the evils as hard as we can. We want to transform the world that we live in into a better place. But we also know that our efforts cannot completely change the world, no matter how hard we worked. The ultimate change in our world has to come from the Lord. The Lord also gave the promise that he will come again. "My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, so that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." John 14:2-4. The angels told the same thing when the Lord was ascended. They were looking intently up into the sky as he was going, when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. "Men of Galilee," they said, "why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus, who has been taken from you into heaven, will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven." Acts 1:10-11. So believers anxiously waited for his return from the beginning of the churches. Some even tried to hasten his return through human efforts. But it completely depends upon the sovereign will of the Father only. But about that day or hour no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Matthew 24:36. Definitely, now the time is near. That's what the angel told clearly to John. In verse 10, the angel said, "Do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this scroll, because the time is near." Not only that, he told Lord's message that he would come quickly repeatedly in verses 7 and 12. He said, "Look, I am coming soon. Blessed is the one who keeps the words of the prophecy written in this scroll." Then he said again, "Look, I am coming soon. My reward is with me, and I will give to each person according to what they have done." Of course, he hasn't come yet. If the Lord has stressed the urgency of his return in such a way, we should take heed to it and be prepared to meet him. But it could be any time. So how prepared and ready to meet him? Are you keeping the words of the prophecy written in this scroll as he urged? Are you living in a way that would be worthy of his reward?